Hello, welcome to the EMP Tech Group. Not back in the shop. I'm up here in the nerve center, as I call it, with Chris Compton, and upstairs here at the EMP Tech Group is our engineering group. And so we've got programmers here, and we've got you and Chad sitting here, who are the support guys and the software support guys, hardware support guys. You're also our wireless networking guy. So you've got all your toys for doing site surveys over here. And Chris, you're also our SOTI guy, our primary SOTI guy. So you have been working for the past, I don't know, few weeks to get a new feature that's in SOTI now, working for us to have here as a demo, but also for us to show customers, and that's device tracker. So mobile computers, preferably Zebra mobile computers, but really any mobile computer, you can, used to be you could kind of track what access point it was under, but now you can actually triangulate off of access points and tell exactly where it is, right?
Yeah, so they've added indoor tracking. They've always had outdoor tracking, so if you had cellular devices, you could track the devices, but now they're adding indoor tracking. Obviously, it's based on how many access points you have, how accurate that is.
And it doesn't work on every wireless network, right? It works on Juniper, it works on Extreme, and there's two Ciscos that it works on.
Cisco, and then they're adding Mist.
Okay, got it. Cool. So if you have one of those wireless networks and you have SOTI, not MobiControl though, SOTI XSight, yep, which is now MobiControl XS. They've actually bundled those and branded it. You can do this real-time device tracking. And while we're here, I want to also talk about what XSight does on top of MobiControl as well.
Right.
And in a nutshell, MobiControl can show you, here's what's going on with the device right now. You can remote into the device. But with XSight, you can also go, what's been going on with the device for the past 30 days?
Correct.
So if somebody had a problem yesterday afternoon, I can look at what was their battery life, what was their signal strength, what apps were they running, things like that, right?
Correct. Yeah. It's the advanced analytics part of MobiControl. MobiControl, you're locking down the device. You can see what's actively happening. You can set up alerts and warnings, but actually tracking what's going on, what apps are being opened, how much battery life, how much Wi-Fi, those type of things, the analytics that go back in history and even can look in the future to see whether you're going to have future issues, those are all in XSight.
I love the word forensics. So if you had an incident yesterday and you need to do some forensics, it's not, you know, because with just MobiControl, you go, well, it looks fine now. Yep. But with XSight, you can go, well, let's look at what it was yesterday.
Yeah, exactly.
Cool. So show what you got on the screen.
Yeah. So currently on the screen, we have the default landing page of XSight, which is your battery information. Tells you how much battery is on the devices, what is using the battery. So if you come down here, it tells you what apps and software are using battery.
Because some apps will use the battery harder than others, right?
Yeah. Anything that's graphical or something is going to use those. Nice. One thing that's pretty cool is you can look at this as an overlay and you can bounce between these apps. You can look at what app usage is, network usage is. Typically, I feel like if you're using this software, you're probably tracking one specific device or area or issue. So what you can do is come down here and click on a specific device.
Drill down.
And drill right down into it.
And now's when you can see kind of past history then, right?
Yeah, so I can see the past history. Right now it's on 7 days and, like you said, up to a month.
Okay, great.
So I can look at app usage and what apps are being used on here. So as you can see, 123 RFID. This is our RFID model.
That's great, because our test device for this is a Zebra big and robust RFID sled with a TC58 inside of it. Great. So nice.
Yeah, we don't have a SIM card in it yet, but eventually we'd be able to even track the cellular on this. So right now you can see we've bounced between Enterprise Browser, CC Mobility, which was another customer. We were testing some apps for them and some other add-ons. But you can come over here. You can look at your data usage. So how much data is this unit using?
Historically. Nice. Yeah,
very much so. So big one, like we were just talking about, is always Wi-Fi, right? Like, what was your Wi-Fi range? And as you'll see, this bounces around, but these are wonderful signals. I mean, you're going to get full
Everything's above, way above. Yeah.
So And speaking of that, right, you see your Wi-Fi and all that. So the other thing that you can obviously do is last locationing. And then that's when you can get into indoor locationing and those things. So we talked about this before, but people watching don't know. We only have two access points on our, you know, up here in the offices. So we're not going to get great triangulation. But you'll see through the video that, you know, you can actually see the device move when we move it around. It even gives you the geolocation based on where it thinks it is on Earth. And then it also shows you a picture of where it is.
Yeah, because you're on Google Earth right here, right? So zoom that out. Just kind of show, because it's, you know, you're zoomed in on our building, but you actually can show where in the world. And so if a customer, say a customer had four warehouses all kind of closely clustered together, you could see what building that device was in too.
Yeah, you could definitely do that.
And then zoom in and see where in the building it is.
Yep. Yeah. And you can go in and if we go back here to this other screen, this is called Live View. This is the next step to what we were just looking at. And when you look at this view, you can come in here and you can look at live data. So I can track through time what this device has been giving us. And you can actually set this up to where it tells us what has been happening. So I can do a time machine and say, how many hourly drops has it had on the wireless?
Oh, nice.
Has it physically been dropped? What apps have they been using? And like I said, that's where I was getting, it gets even as detailed as your actual latitude and longitude of
okay.
the device.
And how precise this is depends on your wireless network, right?
Right.
But most people don't need to know, is it here or is it here? They need to know, is it in this room?
Correct.
Oh, by the way, geofence it, because if it leaves the building or it leaves the area it's supposed to be in, give me an alert, right?
Correct. Yeah. Right. You can have alerts set up to where if it leaves, eventually they are looking at even adding geofencing to where if I was over here, let's say this is quality, and I walk over here and this is shipping, you could actually geofence and have the apps change and do other stuff or notifications that the device has left the area.
Yeah, fun.
So
okay, great.
That is a future look on that.
And I started to say this earlier, how accurate this is depends on your AP.
Yep.
Because you need three to triangulate off of, and you only have two. But even with the two access points we have now, you can tell about where it is, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, we get pretty good locationing within, I'd say, about 15 feet or so.
Okay.
So not too bad. Obviously, and every Wi-Fi is different. I was telling you that, like, Extreme wants them to be every 32 feet apart. Cisco's was different. I think that they were more like 40 to 50 feet apart. So everyone's going to be a little bit different. So if you want actual accurate, you need to listen to the manufacturer.
If you want to know within a foot where it is, yeah, you're probably going to have some pretty dense access
Correct.
Point coverage.
Correct.
But if you want to know if it's what room it's in, you don't have to populate Correct. A whole bunch of access points.
So this is the indoor locationing. Other things that we haven't have been in XSight for a long time, but we've never actually necessarily pushed, is this is a ticketing system. So full ticketing system, you can come in here, you can have the user chat, video chat, voice chat to the person, you can remote control the device while watching it, and take diagnostics live while talking to a person if you're having issues.
And that's what XSight does above MobiControl.
Correct.
Right? Yeah, nice.
Yeah,
nice.
So pretty neat little ticketing system to where you can see, you know, how important something is, who assigned it, and then get devices fixed and push it through.
XSight's been around for a while. It's had some justification for the extra cost, but now with this device locationing, it's almost a no-brainer. And we've had customers, you've been here for 17 plus years, so you've seen it as much as I have, customers going, how can I locate my devices inside the four walls? MobiControl would give you outside for cellular devices,
yep,
but we never really had a good solution for tracking those devices inside the four walls. And if you're a warehouse, it's got a million square feet with 300 devices, suddenly that's a big deal.
Yeah, very much so.
And now we have that. And it's not that much more. I mean, it's more than MobiControl, but it's not crazy expensive. What you've had to do here is first you had to go to Extreme and get what from Extreme so that we could do
this. So you have to have at least Pilot. The nice thing about that is to be honest with you, if you have more than 10 devices, you have to pay for Pilot anyways on Extreme.
Okay.
So I went ahead and had us get Copilot, which is one step higher than that, just so that we had full features. But to do just the tracking part of it, you need Pilot. So anything over 10 devices, you have to have that anyways with Extreme. Cisco, they have their own API. But really, the APIs weren't that much. I think whenever you guys looked at the cost, it was very minimal.
So first, you have to get your wireless network. It has to be one that's approved.
Right.
And you have to get whatever software features you need. So it will locate the devices and then send that data out to SOTI XSight.
Yeah. So currently what is happening is you buy the software. It gives you an API. That API now attaches to SOTI XSight. Yeah. And then they actually are passing the locationing data. Now, I just talked to SOTI the other day. They're actually switching it. They're going to just pull the API information and do all location and internal.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he said probably the last version in 2025 will start doing that. Because they said they actually did say, talking with Cisco and whatnot, it's too difficult to make sure that they stay on top of it. So if they just get the data, they're just going to do it.
Okay, so does that mean you can do that with any network, because they'll just pull that data?
As long as it has an external API, that's what they're thinking. Is
that'll
open
it
up
to
more.
About anything.
Right,
yeah.
Right. They're still going to stick to the first four to
which
start
they
with.
Say is like 80% of the market of what's out there.
I would say,
anyway.
I mean, Cisco,
yeah.
Obviously, you know, we run into Juniper everywhere. Quite a bit.
Yeah. All of the big customers, anybody running SAP is probably running Cisco.
Right.
So, yeah,
right.
Cool. Okay, well, again, decades old problem. Trying to locate mobile computers. I've told this story over and over again, where we'll go in and we'll sell a customer 200 or 300 devices, and then maybe they're leasing them, or maybe they just have a hard turn on when they're going to turn those devices over. We'll go back and they go, we're missing 50 devices.
Yep.
We didn't even know we were missing 50 devices. Oh, by the way, 50 devices times two, that's $100,000 of the devices we've lost.
Yep.
This will help stop that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll give them the power to know where it should be in their warehouses, gives you advanced analytics on devices losing batteries, stuff like that.
Managing batteries. I got a Wi-Fi problem. This will help you troubleshoot that. So some amazing stuff. One of my favorite stories, when we go to that customer and we go, yeah, you've been losing devices. You've probably been shipping them out. They'll say, yeah, we get them in on the trucks coming into us all the time. They'll look, there's a Zebra MC device on the truck. So this will help stop that from happening.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And at least alert people right away so that they can find these things.
With guys like you on staff, Chris, end to end. I mean, we're not going to go to the customer, we'll help you with this part of it, but you got to do it. No, we'll help you with the whole thing. Yeah. And we'll sell you the SOTI licenses, and then we'll sell them your time to help get it all up and going. And you've done this multiple times, so you can really expedite getting things spun up.
Yeah, I mean, even right now, we've been doing the new training in SOTI. We try to stay up to date, and obviously we have multiple people on staff that, you know this software and can definitely implement it.
Well,
that's why I spent the last 3 weeks working on how to do this in step-by-step, how to do it so that we can definitely help.
So we're not learning as we're trying to help a customer.
Right.
We're investing in it ahead of time. So when a customer comes to us, you've already done it. You've done it here.
Yeah, and the indoor locationing has only been out for 2 months.
Yeah.
So
nice.
We're up to date.
Cool. So EMP Tech Group, best place to reach us. Thanks for watching today.